Amber's husband, Carl, is an artist. Can you guess which one of these ladies is Amber? It's the lady in the middle. She has the same paint stains on her clothes as Carl has on his jeans. Carl gets an invitation to visit a mysterious fortune teller, Morgana. She has built a maze so that only smart people could reach her house. Which one of these routes should Carl choose? Only the first path will take him to the final destination. Morgana treats Carl with a welcome drink. Only one of these three drinks is safe. Can you guess which one? The first drink. There's a human tooth inside the second glass, and there are too many flies around the third drink, so it's probably not fresh. Morgana says,
I've got a surprise for you. People put it on the table but never eat it. What is it?
Can you guess? The correct answer is a pack of cards. Carl gets his brand new pack of cards. Morgana offers him a mind game. From the pack of 52 cards, she places 4 cards on the table face down and gives Carl 4 clues about the card. Card on the left cannot be greater than the card on the right. The difference between the first card and the third card is 8. There's no single ace among these 4 cards. Also, there are no face cards. And finally, the difference between the second and the fourth card is 7. Can you help Carl guess the values of all 4 cards? Alright, let's put everything on the table. The task was to guess the value so we can pay no attention to the suits. The first card has to be 2, and the third card has to be 10. There's simply no other way the difference can be 8. The first and the fourth clues reveal that the fourth card can only be 10. And, thanks to clue 5, we know that the second card amounts to 3. So here's the correct answer. Carl successfully solves the riddle. Morgana is impressed. She says,
Now that I see you deserve my gift, I will give you a magic amulet that will turn you into the richest artist. These 3 tunnels lead to the room where the treasure is hidden. You must choose wisely if you want to stay safe.
There's a rhino cuddling her calves in the first tunnel. The second tunnel is filled with gas, which is fatal for any insect. There are thousands of venomous snakes crawling around the third tunnel. Which way is more or less safe? The second one. Nobody said that the gas is dangerous for humans. The next day, Carl feels sick and goes to the hospital. He meets these 3 women in the lobby. Can you find a doctor's wife among them? Take a look at the poster. This doctor is a dentist. The first lady is his patient. And the third one is his colleague, so the second lady is his wife. 3 doctors approach Carl, but one of them is fake. Can you guess who? Take a look at this guy's badge. There's a female picture and a name on it, so he's probably an imposter. The doctor invites Carl to his lab. Can you help him find these 3 items? Here they are! In the evening, Carl arrives home. He spots 5 weird things about this place right away. Can you see them too? The house number is hanging upside down. This raccoon is talking on a cell phone. The bicycle is moving without a rider. This lantern doesn't have a lamppost and floats in the air by itself. And finally, these flowers in the garden are blooming in the middle of winter. Carl enters his house. Surprise! His friends prepared a secret party for his birthday. Everything goes well, but suddenly the lights turn off for 30 seconds. When the power is back again, Carl sees that someone has sneaked his lucky amulet from his neck. He questions three suspects. Rick says, "I was cooking snacks in the kitchen. The light turned off so suddenly." Bella says, "I was in the middle of a chess game when the power turned off." And Ren says, "I've been dancing in the living room for the last 30 minutes, and the dark didn't stop me." Who's lying? Bella. She said she was in the middle of her game, but all chess pieces are standing in their initial positions. Bella escapes with the amulet and flies away to Seychelles with her boyfriend, Josh. Can you guess which one of these guys is Josh? The second guy. He's lying on her beach wrap. Bella is watching a boxing match on TV. It's a friendly match between two heavyweights, which consists of 12 rounds, but it was finished after the 7th round because the boxer knocked out the other one. But during the match, no man threw even a single punch. How can this be possible? Easy. It was between two female boxers. In the hotel, Bella has only three neighbors on her floor. One of them is turning into a zombie. Can you guess who? This lady, it's hot. Why is she wearing a warm scarf? Bella leaves her hotel room to get some ice. 2 minutes later, she returns and finds out that someone had broken in. How did she know? When she was leaving, the balcony door was opened and now it's locked. It was Carl who robbed Bella. He just took back his amulet and ran away to the roof. Unfortunately, now he's trapped on the roof of the hotel building. It's 200 feet high. There's a hook on the roof and another hook 100 feet down from it. Carl finds a 150-foot long rope and a sharp knife. How can he climb down safely? Carl should cut the rope into two parts, 50 and 100 feet. Then make a knot at the end of the shorter rope and put the longer one through it. Then he should slide down the ropes and untie the longer rope to be able to use it again with the second hook. Carl uses his lucky amulet and his art becomes super famous. One day, he receives a phone call from the police. They arrested a group of criminals who tried to sell illegal copies of Carl's artwork. They confiscated three paintings. Carl said that one of them is original. Can you guess which one? The first painting is a mirrored version of the original work. The second one has a barely visible handprint. Therefore, only the third painting is original. Carl exhibits a huge collage in a gallery. Can you spot any outstanding images? This guy over here. Carl goes to the gym for a morning workout. He sees something weird and freaks out. Can you spot what's wrong? A huge spider is crawling out of the ventilation. Carl puts his bags in a locker before going to the gym shower. He locks it and takes the key with him. He hangs the key on a hook together with his towel. After bathing, Carl finds out that someone had stolen the key and robbed his locker. He questions three suspects, but all of them say they were taking a shower and didn't see anything. Who is lying? The third guy. Take a look at his feet. They're too dirty for a man who has just taken a shower. Wendy is an art teacher. This morning, someone pranked her by putting glue on her coffee mug. She questioned three suspects. Blair says,
"I didn't do it. I was too busy painting these beautiful flowers."
Jason says, "I overslept and came to the studio later than you." And Zara says,
"Why would I do that? You're my favorite teacher."
Who did it? It was Zara. There's a glue pen in her pocket. Wendy gives her students a task and leaves the studio. After a while, she returns and sees this painting. She says,
"Wow, who painted this masterpiece?"
Three students claim to be the author of the painting. Can you guess who tells the truth? To solve this mystery, we should take a look at their palettes. Only this student has all colors that match the painting. Wendy goes outdoors to buy some food for lunch. Suddenly, she sees a cyclist lying on the ground. Can you guess what happened here? In fact, the car hit the ketchup bottle. The cyclist just fell nearby and got stained. Wendy receives a delivery, three identical boxes with artist supplies. All boxes are labeled incorrectly. Wendy needs to label all boxes correctly by opening just one of them. Can you help her? Since all three boxes contain the wrong items, Wendy should open the third box. If it contains watercolor, the first box will definitely have brushes, and the second box, watercolors and brushes. And if she finds brushes in the third box, the first one will contain both watercolors and brushes, while the second one, watercolors only. The delivery guy walks outside and yells, "Hey, call the police! Someone stole my car!" The police begin an investigation and find these three suspects. One of them is a thief. Can you guess who? The first guy is just coloring his fence, and the third one is a gardener. But the second guy is hiding a lockpick in his shirt pocket, so he's the thief. Wendy comes to a party. Three guys invite her to dance, but one of them is a werewolf. Can you guess who? The first guy is just wearing a werewolf costume. The second one has some scratches, but it proves nothing. But the third one has a real wolf tail. After the party, Wendy wakes up in a cell made of ice. She only has a pickaxe in her hand. Meanwhile, her best friend Zach is locked in a similar cell with a drill. Can you predict who will escape? Only Wendy will escape. Zach can't use a drill without electricity. The next day, Wendy arrives at the art studio. She leaves her takeaway coffee at the desk and goes to the toilet. Wendy returns and finds out that someone had drunk her beverage. She checks the cup surface for fingerprints, but she only finds her own traces. Wendy questions three suspects among students. Blair says,
"Sorry, I've been washing my brushes in the sink. I didn't look at your desk."
Jason says, "Sorry, I don't like coffee, and besides, I've been streaming stories for my followers." And Robin says,
"I was changing in the dressing room to be a model for portrait class."
Can you spot the thief?
It was Jason. Take a look at his back pocket. He's hiding rubber gloves. That's why he didn't leave any fingerprints. Wendy receives an emergency call. Someone had stolen paintings from her art studio gallery. Wendy interrogates three suspects among the visitors. Sarah says,
I came here to buy some of your paintings, but when I entered the gallery, the walls were empty.
Jill says,
I went blind 7 years ago, so I didn't see anything. I only visit this gallery to use your toilet.
And Robert says, why would I rob this place? I'm the major investor.
Who's lying?
Jill, if she's really blind, why did she bring this photo camera with her?
Wendy carries out entrance exams for art students. One of these three artists is left-handed. Can you guess who?
It's the third guy. It's easier for lefties to hold a palette in their right hand and paint with their left. This way, his left hand works and the right one stays static. During exams, one guy named Bobby gets very sick and faints. Wendy calls the ambulance and takes him to the hospital. She's just met Bobby, so she doesn't know his relatives. But still, Wendy manages to notice his wife in the hospital right away. Can you spot her too? It's the first lady. They have identical tattoos, and the third lady has a similar mole on her cheek, so she's probably Bobby's sister. Doctors suspect poisoning, so they keep Bobby in the hospital to make tests. Meanwhile, Wendy returns to the studio and questions three witnesses among the applicants. Sheila says,
Bobby didn't look healthy in the first place. I don't blame him. Everyone was stressed out during exams.
Sam says,
I have no idea who poisoned him, but this person is heartless.
And Xavier says,
I think Bobby's just pretending to be ill to get accepted out of pity.
The next day, Bobby calls Wendy with the test results. He was poisoned. Wendy calls the police right away and they arrest one of the witnesses. Can you guess who and why?
Sam. He knew about the poison before the test results were ready. The next morning, Wendy enters the studio and sees that someone has left a hot mess. Canvases are torn and paints are spilled all over the floor. Can you count all the brushes in this room?
Thirteen. What about the glass jars? Can you count the exact number? There are eight glass jars in this studio, including this broken one. Wendy asks her three students,
who's responsible for this mess?
Nina replies,
I think it was David. He never washes his hands and clothes. He's such a weirdo.
David says,
it was Nina. She's just jealous because her paintings weren't selected for an art exhibition.
And Amber says,
I don't know who did it. Yesterday, I was feeling sick and stayed home.
Who's responsible for this mess? Take a look at the canvas frames. They're all signed. The only canvas that wasn't torn has David's name on it. Therefore, he ruined the studio and his rival's works. Wendy asks her students to the park for an en plein air class. Can you see any weird details in this area? This is an apple tree. But why are there so many oranges under it? Two students have painted almost identical pictures. Can you help Wendy find three differences? Here they are. What about these portraits? Can you spot three differences?
over here. After the class, Wendy is trying to leave the park and gets lost. She has to walk through this confusing maze. Can you help her find the way out? Only the first path is correct. On the way home, Wendy enters a supermarket. Can you count the number of cacti? Six. Someone had broken the most expensive car in the parking lot near Wendy's apartment building. The police interrogate three witnesses to find out who's guilty. Carl says,
"This is my car. I parked it as usual and went home. Wendy woke me up with her call."
Gia says,
"I was just having a yoga class in a studio nearby. This car belongs to my ex-boyfriend Carl. Too bad he loved this car more than me."
And Peter says,
"Carl's my neighbor, but he's not my best friend, if you know what I mean. I've been working all day and just arrived."
Who broke Carl's car? It was Gia. She's hiding a baseball bat inside her yoga mat. This is the best test to check your observation skills. It has several levels, and each is more difficult than the previous one. Do you think you'll pass it? Let's see. And remember to note down your score. One correct answer is 1 point. Level 1, for rookies. Which person is different from the others? Right, it's the one whose hair is visibly shorter. Try to find a C in this sea of O's. Heh, did you like the pun? The bottom left corner, see? Oh-ho, it seems there are only letters S in this image. But not really. There's also the number 5 hiding there. Here it is. I challenge you to find a cat that is different from the rest. Right, it's the one closer to the bottom, facing away from you. Can you find the odd bat in this picture? Right, it's this one. Its wings are a bit different than those of its mates. Can you find the odd image? Yep, it's the M among all those W's. One of the dogs is different from the rest. Which pooch is it? Ah yes, the one with its mouth closed. Can you find an O among all those Q's? Right you are, it's almost in the center of the picture. Can you find the odd number? Yep, it's hiding among dozens of nines. Something really spooky is going on in this picture. What is it? There's a snake in a jar of pickles. There's a deer in this picture. The poor thing doesn't want to be found, but can you see it? A small hint. Check behind the tree. One of these clovers is unlucky. It has only 3 leaves.
Can you spot it? Yep, it's the one in the bottom row. Try to find the odd image. It's the house with a little red window. How many dolphins can you see in this picture? Well, it's been a tough feat to find all 17. Can you find F in this image? Well, it was pretty tough, but here it is. Level 2, for experienced riddle crackers. Can you figure out what's wrong in these pictures? Something seems to be off in this image, but what? Surely they didn't have pacifiers in the Stone Age. Even though this picture seems okay, there's a mistake in it. The numbers on the dial are mixed up. 11 goes before 9. I'm sure you'll be able to spot a bizarre detail in this picture. Oops, she must have been in a hurry this morning. Otherwise, why would she put on boots if it's obviously summer? Can you figure out what's wrong in this picture? It looks like a regular electric kettle to me. Minimum is always at the bottom and maximum is at the top. This picture seems weird, but why? The clock on the tower shows 2 o'clock. No matter if it's AM or PM, sunsets or sunrises don't usually happen at this time. Something's off in this picture. Care to figure out what? Exactly. Pigeons don't normally swim among ducks, or come to think of it, at all. Look at the picture and try to figure out what's wrong here. Some of the price tags are placed upside down. I can feel there's something terribly wrong with this picture. Can you figure out what it is? It's raining heavily, and the girl in a green dress doesn't have an umbrella. And still, she looks dry and happy. Are you attentive enough to say what's wrong in this picture? Is that Earth in the sky? Then what planet is this? Does this picture seem okay to you? Well, a banana is a strange ingredient for stew. I know something's wrong in this picture, but I can't grasp what exactly. Can you? The calendar claims it's 2022, but on the computer screen, you can see a different year, 2023. It's strawberry harvest time. Yummy. Only, doesn't it seem to you that something's off? Strawberries don't grow on bushes. And
What's wrong with this image? Where does all that water falling from the cliff disappear to? Is there a hole in the ground or something? Can you spot anything wrong in this picture? I'm quite sure butterflies don't fly in the winter. Have you noticed anything strange in this picture? It's the ball. This one is for playing soccer, not volleyball. Level 3 for top-notch detectives. One apple is different from the rest. Can you find it? Right, the worm living inside this apple doesn't look as green and plump as the others. Try to find the odd light bulb. Phew, that wasn't easy. Look at these burgers. Does any of them stand out? Ah, this burger is a bit smaller than the rest. Two identical snowmen as fast as you can. Here they are, the coolest ones. Which penguin is different from its siblings? Ha, gotcha! There are actually two penguins that are different from the rest. The one with the black belly and the one looking in the opposite direction. Are these two squares of the same color or are they different? The color is the same. To make sure it's true, cover the line with your finger. Voila! Something is wrong in this picture, but I can't figure out what exactly. The fairy lights on the tree are shining, but they aren't plugged in. There's something wrong in this image, but to figure out what, you need to be very attentive. This guy is wearing swimming goggles instead of sunglasses. Can you find four errors in this picture? Well, what should I start with? Fishing at the skating rink? Cycling on the ice? Plus, that woman's kid is actually a puppy, which is quite alarming. Also, wearing roller skates instead of ice skates while skating on the ice is a risky feat. Now, look at this image. A guy looking in the mirror. Nothing strange at first sight, but can you spot one bizarre detail? Look, the guy's shoes are white, but in the reflection, they're yellow. Can you find three words hidden in this wintry picture? These words are snow. It's over there, in that snowdrift, see? Then we have blizzard. It's hidden in the cloud. And finally, you've probably spotted ice on that guy's knitted hat. Now the task is getting even trickier. There are five words hidden in this image. Do you think you can find them all? Coffee is written on the leg of that table in the corner. T is hiding under the waiter's apron. You'll find the word cake, surprise, surprise, on that yummy-looking piece of cake. The word fork is over there on the ceiling. And finally, there's the word tasty written on that guy's sports bag. Now tell me, do you see anything wrong in this picture? It looks like fall with all those yellow and orange leaves, but this little bush in the corner is blooming. This forest is full of wild animals, but can you find one that doesn't belong? Most likely, it's this little puppy hiding behind the fir tree. I'm not sure it's supposed to be here alone without its human parents. And the toughest of them all, can you find two identical castles? They all look so bright and elaborate and have so many decorations, but these two are 100% identical. I know you've been waiting for this, your results. Okay, let's see. If your score is 0 to 15 points, you need to learn to pay more attention to small details. But don't worry, as soon as you start working more on your observation skills, your results will get much better. If you've got 16 to 30 points, you have a sharp eye for detail. If you practice more, you'll become a pro in no time. If you have 31 to 45 correct answers, you can spot the tiniest details and figure out the answers to the trickiest riddles. Nothing can escape your eagle eye.
Ashley is a stewardess. She finds this cute puppy running around in the airport. Three people come over and claim to be its owner. Can you guess who's telling the truth? This guy. His tattoo matches the dog's name. Ashley walks to her flight gate and passes by this waiting area. But then the gate changes, so she has to walk through that place once again. Ashley spots 10 differences. Can you see them too? Here they are. Ashley is checking passengers' passports before letting people on board. Suddenly, the security service calls her with a warning. One of the passengers is using a fake ID. Ashley finds three suspects. Can you spot the fake passport out? There's no February 31st, so this passport is definitely fake. Finally, the plane is taking off. Ashley takes a look at the passengers and spots three odd things. Can you see them too? This lady has two safety belts. This guy is talking on the phone. It should be put in airplane mode. And the view behind this window doesn't match reality. There's no hot lunch on this flight, but you can buy it additionally. The price for chicken is set at $15, and the beef costs $12. Can you guess the price of a fish lunch? The cost of one vowel is $5, and the cost of a consonant, $1. Fish has three consonants and one vowel, so it costs $8. One of the passengers, Josh, calls Ashley. He begins to complain. Someone had stolen my phone when I was in the toilet. Ashley questions three people sitting nearby. What happened when Josh was away? Chelsea says, "Sorry, I was watching a movie, so I didn't look around at all." Bobby says, "I was reading a book, but I think I heard the sound of a rustled plastic bag." And Nina says, "I was sleeping. You woke me up with your stupid questions. Who stole the phone?" Nobody. It's still in Jeff's pocket. Ashley checks the business class passengers and spots one witch among them. Can you see her too? This lady is hiding a magic wand. Ashley lands in a foreign country and sends her boyfriend this message. Can you guess what country she's in? Singapore. Ashley goes to her hotel by train. She sees these two billboards on the way. She can't decide if they're identical. Can you spot any differences? In fact, there are 5 differences. Ashley goes to the local restaurant. There's an open kitchen, and she can see the chef at work. Ashley makes an order and leaves for the ladies' room for a while. When she returns, she spots 10 differences in the kitchen. Can you see them too? Here they are. Ashley sees a group of office workers having lunch together. Suddenly, their boss spills hot coffee on his laptop because his palm is stuck to his mug. One of these 3 co-workers pranked their boss. Can you guess who? It's the lady in the middle. She's wearing double-sided tape as a bracelet. Suddenly, one of the guests in the restaurant faints. The manager calls an ambulance. The doctors arrive very quickly and take him to the hospital. The police question witnesses. The cook says, "This guy didn't order any food. He just asked for a glass of water." The waitress says, "He looked so gloomy. I decided to cheer him up and served his water in a silver glass." The manager says, "He called us in advance to reserve a table in the corner. He insisted that I must send him an official invitation." And the cleaner says, "I saw him washing hands in the restroom. I swear he didn't have any reflection." Can you guess what happened here? The guest was a vampire, and he got sick because of the silver. Ashley is visiting the local farmer's market. A group of tourists asks her to take their pictures. One of them is not from this planet. Can you guess who? This lady. She's eating a pomegranate with the peel. Ashley wants to chill at this beautiful beach, but she sees a zombie among the guests. Can you spot it too? It's this guy who's reading a book upside down. Ashley goes hiking and gets lost. She finds a sign that shows 3 possible ways out. Unfortunately, each path hides some danger. There's a toxic marsh that swallows people on the first path. The second path is a hunting place for vampires. And the third path holds thousands of venomous snakes. Which way is more or less safe? Ashley should choose the second path. Vampires only hunt at night. Ashley, Nellie, Sarah, and Melissa are co-workers and friends. They land in Paris and come to a party together. But at a certain point, they find out that Ashley had disappeared. She was locked in the basement of the music hall. Can you guess who did it? It was Melissa. Pink sequins from her fancy dress lay by the door. Ashley receives this rebus from her boss. Can you guess which country is her next destination? She's going to Belgium. Ashley is packing her bags for the trip. How many emojis can you see here? Here they are. Ashley is having breakfast at the airport. Can you find any emojis in this food? There are three, actually. In the waiting area, Ashley meets her old school friend, Kelly. They go to the local coffee shop to chat. Suddenly, Kelly begins to yell, "Please help me! My suitcase is gone!" Ashley questions three witnesses. One of the passengers, Paul, says, "This is my suitcase. I've already wrapped it in plastic to protect it from scratches." Nina says, "I went to the restroom and asked the barista to look after my luggage." And the barista says, "I looked after Nina's luggage and I didn't look around. Sorry. Can you figure out the thief?" It's Paul. There's a sticker with Kelly's name under the plastic. Ashley enters the plane. There's an imposter among the flight crew. Can you help Ashley find this person? It's this stewardess. Take a look at her uniform. The air company logo is a little different compared to all the others. Ashley lands in Brussels. She walks into the local park and takes two pictures. Can you find 10 differences between them? Here they are. A motorbike rider asks Ashley to take his picture. She takes two. Are they identical? There are three differences, actually. In the hotel, Ashley meets an opera diva, Esmeralda, who's having a world tour. She has visited almost all the countries, and she has finally arrived at the last one.
Oh, no.
In the morning, a maid finds Esmeralda unconscious in her room. The police arrive and find out that Esmeralda was poisoned. They question the suspects. Esmeralda's husband says, "She wanted to be in bed early, so I went to the lobby for the night." Esmeralda's manager says, "I was in my room all evening. I was preparing for the concert." And the hotel waitress says, "I only brought her juice in the evening. She was fine." The police check fingerprints in the room and find many prints on the glass. Who poisoned Esmeralda? It was the manager. She said she didn't leave the room, but there are prints on the glass. In the morning, Ashley is having her next flight, but her taxi breaks on the way. She's stuck at the gas station 50 miles away from the airport. Three drivers stop, offering to give Ashley a ride. Which car would you choose? The first car is stolen, and the third driver is a runaway criminal, so Ashley should choose the second car. Ashley returns home and puts all her cash into her stash as usual. The next evening, she returns home and realizes that someone had stolen her money. How did she guess? Ashley's cash was in the globe. Its parts don't match anymore. Somebody opened it when Ashley was out.
Erica wants to find her true love, so she's visiting a speed dating event. She talks to three strangers. Each guy tells her some brief facts about himself. Victor says, "I'm an architect. I've recently built the largest skyscraper in this city, and now I want to settle down and find a beautiful wife." Jason says, "I run my own bakery chain. I've never had any serious relationships because I was too busy with my work." And Edgar says, "I recently got fired, but it's okay because my parents are billionaires. I'd like to find a soulmate to travel the world."
Who should Erica choose?
Take a closer look at Victor. His teeth are too sharp. He doesn't eat or drink anything, and he doesn't have any shadow. It's not safe to date a vampire. As for Jason, he clearly wore a wedding ring. There's a tan line on his ring finger. Therefore, he's a liar. That's why Erica should choose Edgar. After the event, Erica enters her favorite Indian restaurant near her apartment. She makes an order, puts her bag on one of the tables, and goes to the restroom. After a couple of minutes, she returns and finds out that someone had stolen her bag. The waiter says,
"I saw someone with a neck tattoo running into the restaurant's second floor."
Erica goes upstairs and finds three possible suspects. Can you spot the thief? This lady is the only one who has a big enough paper bag to hide Erica's bag, and there's also a wig inside her bag. The next day, Edgar calls Erica and invites her on a date. He offers her to pick the place. Erica wants to test Edgar's logical skills. So, she sends him this rebus. Can you help Edgar show up to the right place? This rebus means Central Square. Finally, Edgar and Erica meet at the Central Square. They spot that one of the people in the crowd is a time traveler. Can you guess who? It's this guy. Who's jogging in wooden shoes in the 21st century? Edgar invites Erica to an exclusive party, but unfortunately, the guard refuses to let them in without a password. Edgar says, "Oh, come on, give us a hint." The guard says, "Okay, what time of the day reads the same backward and forward?" Can you help the guys crack the code? The correct answer is noon. The next day, Erica invites Edgar over for dinner. She has some candies in the kitchen. They look similar but have three different flavors: 3 orange, 2 strawberry, and 5 grape candies. Suddenly, the lights turn off in the entire building. Now the kitchen is completely dark. How many candies must Erica take out to make sure she has at least one candy of each flavor? To figure out the minimal number of candies, subtract 1 from the smallest number, and then add all the larger numbers to it, and you'll get 9. Erica locked her computer with a password and wrote some hints on a sticker. Edgar wants to see her shopping list to pick the perfect gift for Valentine's Day. So, in Erica's absence, he tries to log in. Let's take a look at the hints. Can you help him crack this code? It's not just a list of products, see? The correct password is Pilot. Today is Edgar and Erica's wedding day. Man, they move fast. In the morning, the bride is getting ready. First of all, she goes to the shower for 20 minutes. When she returns to her room, she finds out that someone had stained her wedding dress. Only the bridesmaids had access to this dress. So, Erica questions them. Lily says, "In the last 20 minutes, I was chatting with your mom in the living room. She can confirm my words." Rosie says, "I'm not proud of it, but I was in the kitchen secretly eating some snacks prepared for the wedding dinner." And Daisy says, "I've been dealing with a flower shop. They delivered the wrong flowers." Can you guess who stained the dress? It was Rosie. There's the same mud under her shoes. It's time to start the ceremony, but Edgar is missing. his mad ex-girlfriend Zoe is a witch. She sneaked into the wedding, caught Edgar, and cloned him. Erica finds Zoe and six different Edgars in the basement. Zoe says,
I wanted to make some copies of Edgar to keep him with me. Now I have enough. You can take your husband back.
Unfortunately, I don't remember who's the original. Can you help Erica spot the real Edgar? The third one. All the others have paranormal powers. The wedding begins, but there's a thief among the guests. Can you spot this person? It's this innocent-looking lady with two purses. Edgar and Erica are going to India for their honeymoon. Can you see what's wrong with their plane? Open fire is prohibited on board. The stewardess must know that. After landing, Edgar and Erica take a taxi and go to their hotel. Suddenly, they see a family of ducks crossing the road. Erica takes a picture, but unfortunately, it's unfocused. Can you count the exact number of ducks? Let's take a look at one duck at a time. We can see two beaks, so there's another duck behind the first one. And here, we have two little ducks near the bigger one. And this duck is single. So far, the overall sum is six. This guy is not a duck, it's a goose. But there's one more duck hiding behind him, and three more over here. So the overall number is 10. Erica and Edgar arrive at their hotel. Four employees greet them in the lobby, but one of them is an imposter. Can you guess who? Take a look at the logo of this hotel. It's a lotus with six petals, but the logo on this lady's badge has a five-petal lotus. Therefore, she's a fake employee. The hotel manager gives the guys a key to the best room for the newlyweds. They go to check out the room, but when they see the interior, they immediately ask for another one. Why? There's a transparent lizard crawling along the curtains. This potted flower has teeth, and someone is clearly peeping at them through the eyes of this portrait on the wall. Erica, Edgar, and their tour guide go hiking. They have three backpacks, one with sleeping bags and a tent, one with warm clothes and camping gear, and the heaviest one, a backpack with food. Each has to choose one backpack to carry. Erica readily agrees to take the heaviest one. Why? It'll be getting lighter and lighter after each camp. On the way, the guys decide to go explore the local caves. They walk inside and suddenly a landslide blocks the way back. There are four tunnels ahead, each with a sign telling you which dangers lurk inside. There's a family of evil wizards living in the first tunnel. They curse every human who dares to come in. The second tunnel is filled with venomous spiders. The third one is swarmed by bats. And the fourth tunnel is on fire. Which one do you choose to stay safe? They should pick the second tunnel. Spiders don't hurt people for food. Finally, the guys get outside and see a tree with many beautiful parrots. Can you count the exact number of birds in this tree? The task was to count the number of all birds, so there are 10 birds in this tree, including 6 parrots.
In the evening, Erica and Edgar are walking in the city. They see a local parade, but there's a thief among the performers. Can you see him too? This guy is sneaking her bracelet.
Here we go. Stella is a cleaning lady in a three-story business center. Late in the evening, she finishes cleaning the big boss's office. Stella is the last person in the entire building, so she locks the doors and goes home. The next morning, the boss calls her and yells, "Someone wrote scammer on the wall near his desk with blue paint." The boss questions three suspects. The guard said, "I was feeling sick yesterday, so I left earlier and asked Stella to lock all the doors with her keys." The manager says, "This paint was supposed to be used for the basement. I guess someone had stolen the paint from the storage room. As for me, I've spent the evening with my family, and they can confirm my words." And the local interior decorator says, "Yesterday, I was working from home." So, who's guilty? The guard. Take a look at his shoes. He left some footprints on the floor, and they look identical to the paint footprints left in the boss's office. Kyle and Amy are having dinner at a restaurant. Can you spot what's wrong here? She has two forks. You're in a land where 30 men and 2 women are dressed in conservative black and white outfits. They begin to fight as soon as any of them moves. Can you guess where you are? You're on a chessboard. Welcome to the food market. There's a zombie hiding somewhere here. Can you see him? Over here. Can you help the police spot a bank robber in this amusement park? Hello. Let's take a look at all of these emojis. Can you find any food? There's shrimp over here. What about this collection? Can you see anything edible? There are two options, actually. Let's go ahead and see if you can find a building among these emojis. There it is. Next set. Can you see a human among these emojis? Hello. I bet you can find a body part in this variety. This nose over here. Can you see any flowers among all these emojis? There are two flowers actually, here and here. Can you spot what's wrong here? The reflection doesn't match reality. Can you see anything odd here? This lady doesn't have any reflection. Wicked Witch kidnaps young women in the town. The police have been tracking her for 6 months, And finally, they detected her hideout uptown. They break in and find three young ladies with their hands tied. The police questions all women. Sally says, "I've been here for a month or so. I'm so glad you found us." Bella says, "This witch only gave us some bread. We were starving." And Rosie says, "I've spent a month in the darkness. I thought I'd never see the daylight again." The police know at once that one of them is the witch. Can you guess who? Sally. If she had been there for a month, her nails would grow and the nail polish would peel. George works in a museum as an appraisal expert. One day, a stranger brings him three antique Japanese vases. He says, "They're precious. These vases were passed down in my family from generation to generation. They're worth millions, but I would like to sell them to your museum at a huge discount so that everyone can admire them." George examines the vases and finds out that only one of them isn't fake. Can you guess which one? The first piece looks pretty ancient, but why would an ancient Japanese vase have English letters as part of its decoration? The third vase depicts an elegant lady in a traditional costume who's holding a smartphone? Therefore, only the second vase is original. Let's take a look at this collection of emojis. Can you see any gadgets? There are two options, actually. Can you find a body part in this variety? This palm over here. Let's go ahead and see if you can find a building among these emojis. There it is. Next set. Can you see any animals among these emojis? There are three animals here. Can you find any plants among all these emojis? Hello! A powerful wizard kidnaps Kyle's wife. There are three tunnels leading to the dungeon where she's imprisoned. A mother bear is cuddling her cubs inside the first tunnel. The second tunnel is filled with hungry wolves, who haven't been eating for a year. And a fire-breathing dragon is sleeping inside the third tunnel. It can wake up at any moment and burn anyone who dares to enter. Which way is more or less safe? The second path is the safest. Wolves won't survive without food for so long, which means they're not dangerous or breathing. Let's go ahead and see if you can find an outfit among these emojis. It's over here. Let's take a look at this collection of emojis. Can you see any money? Ka-ching! Can you find a shoe in this set? There it is! Next set, can you see any desserts among these emojis? Piece of cake! Literally. Ms. Smith is a rich old lady. Today, she's furious because she's found out that her son is having a secret relationship with one of her staff members. Three women are working in Ms. Smith's mansion. The house cleaner, who has just married their driver, They have a huge debt. The babysitter, who's very poor and brings up 5 siblings. And the gardener, who is a university student. She's not very serious and loves partying. Can you guess who's the secret girlfriend? It's the babysitter. Where did she get money for this jewelry? Billy has lost his cat. Can you help him find it? It's hiding behind this lady. Alex wakes up in a creepy quest room. There are 3 doors, but touching their doorknobs is unsafe. The first one is under high voltage, fatal to humans. The second one is red-hot iron that will burn your hand. And the third one is covered with poison, which is fatal for all beings when injected. Which doorknob should Alex turn to escape? The third one. The poison is only dangerous when injected. Paul leaves his workplace to wash his hands before lunch. He returns to his desk and finds out that someone had eaten his turkey sandwich. Paul checks the crime scene and questions 3 suspects among his co-workers. Mary says, "I've been talking to the manager in his office when the robbery was taking place." Liam says, "I don't need your sandwich, bro. I'm a vegetarian." And Wendy says, "I've been having a conference call in the lobby. I wasn't looking at your desk." Who's lying? Liam, there's a sandwich on his desk. Take a closer look at the package. It says chicken. Therefore, he's not a vegetarian. Can you find any fish among all these emojis? Hello! Let's take a look at this collection of emojis. Can you see any money? Jackpot! Emma takes part in a beauty pageant. She arrives at the auditorium early, gets ready, and has lunch at the local cafeteria because she hasn't been eating or drinking all day. Before going to the stage, Emma faints.
Oh, no.
The doctors find out that someone had poisoned her. The police check all food and drinks at the cafeteria and find no poison. They interrogate 4 witnesses. The cook says, "I only served allergy-friendly snacks and drinks." The contest manager says, "All the models had been eating and drinking the same food, but Emma was the only one who got poisoned. She must have eaten something wrong at home." The rival beauty pageant contestant says, "I've done all the preparations at home, so I've just arrived." And the makeup artist says, "I was too busy with my duties, so I haven't even entered the cafeteria." Can you guess who poisoned Emma? The makeup artist. Lipstick was the only thing that touched Emma's mouth that day, apart from the cafeteria food.